So we've gone through the first part of the video, so I realize it's part two of the video. So in this piece we're going to be setting up our Codeigniter and every other necessary things we did. So basically we're not working with latest version 4.4.2 because I see how we found out, you know, host that on the internet. So we're going to be working with the Codeigniter 4.0.4. Let's just hit enter. Well, you can see this is Codeigniter 4.0. So it's this release, this github.com/codeigniter4/. So this is just going to show you the release of every Codeigniter that has been there from 3 to 4. So you are going to be working with 4.0.4. Just hit this source code and click on download. I already have my downloaded already, so I'm just going to open it up.
Okay.
So I'm going to head over to the downloads and name is framework. Alright, so this is it here. So we double click this, I'm gonna extract this. I'm gonna open with Fly Explorer. Copy this. I'm gonna paste this in my desktop page. So let's also done. So basically as that is going on, so let's set up our Visual Studio code also. So I'm gonna click on the Visual Studio code document. Alright, so you can head back there and just, and basically if you're new to my YouTube channel, please just head over to YouTube. Then you see my YouTube channel, just click on the subscribe button, because I actually watch this video. Just click on the subscribe button and that will actually do a lot to me. Alright, so thank you. So our Visual Studio code is open already. I don't know what it's open to, but it's open. So this tutorial here, we are going to be running our Codeigniter 4. We are going to be testing some redline necessary things we need to do. So let's hold on to this. I wonder why this is taking forever to extract, but let's just hold on. Okay, so I have an application going on here, because so let me just close this. And basically before we get started, make sure you have Visual Studio Code installed. If you don't have Visual Studio Code, you can just, you know, go to your browser and type Visual Studio Code, and you see it's gonna bring it out, and just go ahead and download it. And what other things do I need? Let's check the section here. Extensions. Extensions here. Alright, so. So now this Visual Studio Code here, just click on this download. It will take you to the download page. You select the operating system you want to download it for, either Windows, Mac, Linux. I think there's it for Linux. So select the one you want to use. Like I said, so we just open this extension. Make sure you have PHP, like the PHP extension installed, so that is going to make it easy for you to work with. And so you can leave that side. And while we wait for this search, let's just go ahead. It has an email, so you can install for Windows 7 to 10 upload, Linux, Mac. Right, so I'm using Windows, so I have to just click on this download. I have it downloaded already. If you don't use Visual Studio Code, you can go ahead and install Sublime Text. So basically you can go ahead and install Sublime Text, and Sublime Text also works very well, because before I used Visual Studio Code, I used Sublime Text the most. Alright, so this is Sublime Text here. And I'll go ahead and download it. Alright. And it's very, very, very nice. It has multi-select, which I haven't been able to figure out in Visual Studio Code. So that has extracted successfully, so just have to rename this to. I'm going to rename my phone. Alright, so this is going to be my phone. So we open this folder using Visual Studio Code. So click on File. Go for that, or shortcut Ctrl K, Ctrl O. So let's search for my phone. We select folder. this should open up now. Okay, so it has opened up already. So now take a look, we are gonna take a look at the file structure, and I'm gonna explain to you how it works. Alright, so like you can see, you have this file, it contains the app structure, the app folder, I mean the public folder, the system directory. So this app is where all our controllers, everything, node there's views is included. And this public system is where our product file is gonna be, all our assets, our images, supported CSS somewhere. So yes, system is the API, you know, is actually what makes the Codeigniter4 works. And the writable is just for cache, for session, debugger, and so on and so forth. So we also have the env. So this env makes us, we set up our code data application. We're going to set up the default URL for the database. Use this. We also have this pack for PHP. So we are not going to be touching this because this is what allows us to run Codeigniter4. So we are not going to be touching this. Let's just this type of it. So now let's take a look at the controller. Controller, you have a demo one, which is the own controller. So this own controller has a function in its index, and it's returning the view welcome message. So this is returning the view. This view is looking into this view folder and picking out this welcome message of PHP. So this is actually the welcome message of PHP here. Okay, this is actually the welcome message of PHP. So basically, let us test this now. We can open our same terminal, setting Windows R. Then let's change directory to the desktop, cd desktop slash your folder name, which is my forum. So basically I can just do php spark south. So make sure you have php installed in your path. If you don't have php installed in your path, just name, for example, and it's gonna set that up for you, I'm pretty sure. So let's just copy this and go to the browser and just paste it here. Boom, so we have Codeigniter4 running already. So there's something you're gonna be working with a lot. So first thing we have to do is just, I don't want to touch the controller because that is gonna be in the next video. So we're just gonna work on this only. So let's rename this. Okay. Let's add a dot to it. So we have done this with dot in every file. Okay, good. So what I want us to do here is just remove this from production and comment this, so and move this to development mode. So we are developing right now, so we're doing development mode. Save this. Alright, so it's okay. Then we can refresh this. Now, so it's actually, you know, you can see to confirm the development mode, you're gonna see this. So once you click on this, now you're able to see everything. The available route that is there, which is this one that we are right now. We also have this one is unaccessible because it's a migration route, but this is the only one we have the gets. This one is CLI, that's command line. So we have the views, you can see to show that this view is in the views slash performance of PHP. We have the files, all the files that are loaded there. We have the events that is going on the system. We have the history, so this is actually this loaded page. We have the bars. Alright, so let's confirm if it's actually this one we are loading. So I can go back here and just go to welcome message of PHP, and I can head over down to, now you can see this has its own version, it's doing its own version already. No, we're not gonna do that. Just say welcome to my version. Let's save this. Now reload. I can see welcome to my forum version 4.0.4. So in the next tutorial we'll be looking at controllers and views. Then probably we'll now get started setting everything up. Alright, so next time, thanks.